Hi, my name is Terrel Spangler, and welcome to The Good Side of Crypto, my YouTube channel. I've got an iTunes podcast. By the way, the podcast has some extra audio podcasts that I don't do here on YouTube. But anyway, in this video, I just wanted to take 10 minutes and walk through the layman term, the layman understanding, and a little bit of a technical understanding of how Cardano royalties work. So just recently minted a collection on Cardano blockchain, and there is a lot of stuff. If you Google it, you can find a lot of people wondering, how do I get royalties? How does it work? Do I need smart contracts? I wanted to answer all those questions, all the questions I had, which is, do I need smart contracts to make this work? Do I need to do something and figure this out technically? How do I set this up? Do I set it up myself? Is there a template to use? And so I'm going to do a screen share and show you a little bit about how easy it is and all how it actually works. And so basically the community for Cardano realized that a lot of NFT and creators, NFT makers, creators, pretty much anyone who's wanting to launch on Cardano was waiting for it to be implemented in smart contracts for them to be able to get royalties. So if you're not familiar with how non-fungible tokens, because this is for beginners here, non-fungible tokens work, why you want to consider doing this, why businesses are growing their brands doing this, is because you can launch one or many NFTs, and at first minting, you identify how much royalty you want to receive every time it is resold. So a lot of people weren't coming to Cardano. I would say this is a community-wide acknowledgement because they thought it couldn't do it. So we basically, the community came up with a standard to follow that could scale and be incorporated in the future smart contracts. So the answer to the question is, you do not need smart contracts at this time to receive royalties. You can receive royalties on any NFT project on the Cardano blockchain. And I'm going to show you how it works right now. Let's just do a quick screen share. I'm going to show you how. Here it is. So first of all, CIP0027 is the actual standardization of royalties. This is just a quick view of it on GitHub. I don't expect you to read this. I'm going to show you a little bit more. But basically, how it works for the average person is that when you mint, here's how it works for the average person. Technically, you create a policy ID with meta tag information into a no-name empty token. I guess this is not for layman's person, but for the layman person is when you first mint your NFT, it basically designates three tags. One tells where the royalties are here so that marketplace owners don't have to search meta tag material inside of an asset to figure out what the heck is the royalty, where do I send this stuff. So there was a standard created, and the standard is identified as CIP0027. And I want to show you something really funny because I'm very spiritual. But basically, there are three tags necessary in your metadata. 777 represents this is the royalty information. The second tag, PCT, identifies the percent that you want to have or be sent back to you after your asset resales. So at first minting, you don't get royalties, but when it's resold on a marketplace, you get royalties. And here is where it identifies in the metadata for the marketplace owner. Here's the royalty information. Here is the percentage that this NFT originator wants every time it gets resold. And it can be anywhere between a 0.0 to 1.0, which represents 0 to 100%. And so an example is this 0.05 is what I set, which is 5%. And so if you wanted to do, I mean, if you wanted like a 20% royalty, you would do 0.20. And so if you wanted like a 12.5% royalty, you would do 1.25. And so that's how that works. And then the second tag under 777 is ADDRs, which stands for what is the receiving wallet address that you want to receive the royalties. So what I did when I created the collection was I had the NFTs minted and sent to a wallet address, but I had the royalties sent to another address because some NFTs don't show up on every single wallet inside Cardano. So I had the NFTs sent to a Nami wallet, and I had the royalties sent to a wallet I created on my Daedalus identified as royalties. So basically, no matter what I create, any NFT collection or anything I participate in the future where royalties could be split for me, I want it to go into a royalty wallet. And so that way I would just set that. It's like set it and forget it, right? That's something just to 20 years from now, royalties accumulate. So the technical version is that you create a policy that is empty, and you actually mint that no name. You create a no name token, which is kind of like a holding token, with all the royalty metadata in it. And then you mint the token that is, you create an initial token with the metadata, you mint it with the policy, then you then burn that token that you created with the metadata of royalty information, and then you mint all the assets to the same policy. I guess the point is that there is information initially minted with a policy ID that is to be used by all future marketplace owners. And that is all that is to be used. And no future information regarding royalties will be used other than that initial token that was minted with the policy. So the very first metadata information regarding royalties that's minted with that policy ID is the only one that's ever used, and it can't be changed. And so there's a little bit of an honor system where you're expecting all major NFT marketplaces to adhere to this tag, this 777 tag. But if you want to know something really kind of cool and interesting, if you Google angel number 777, can I just share this with you for a second? It means highly spiritual angel number 777 is the sign of getting divine guidance and indicates it's time to get rewards for your efforts. And that is what royalties are. They are rewards. So I want to show you how this actually is going to work. This is cardanoscan.io, where I initially minted or had adatokenizer.io help me batch mint all 100 NFTs. And so I wanted to like go double check, where is the 777 metadata? Where is the royalty metadata? And so the policy ID. And so here you can see that initially what they did was they minted. Here you can see they minted an unnamed token with metadata royalty information in it. And then here you can see they burned that token. But first you create the token that is empty, right? It's not your first NFT, it's an empty token. And they mint that with this policy ID, and then they burn the token so that it's set. But here, if you click on what was initially created, you can scroll down and click on metadata. And it says right here, label 777. Value is the address that the royalties are to be sent. And then if I just go back one, whoops. And then here I click on the one that was burned, which is identified as a negative one. And it's burned. So first you create it, identify the royalty information based on the tags that are here, right? And if you're not doing this, someone is doing it for you, but it's good to know and it's good to double check. And then they burn that token. The information is already minted to the policy ID. And then they basically create, in my case, the 100, here you have like 101, but 100 NFTs and each of their addresses. So if you go and find an NFT that you have purchased, you cannot see what the originator is going to get from you in royalties. I actually am trying to figure this out on OpenSea for the Ethereum network, but you can't actually do that because if I click on one of the assets, which is 099, number 99 in my 100 collection, you can't actually see the details and metadata of what someone's going to get from you. But what you can see when you sell it and the transaction completes, you can see how much is being taken, obviously, by how much you're going to make on the resale. So that's that. So if you did look up a token, like this is, for example, one of my Wheels Up NFTs, you can see that this is the policy ID, the owner, when it was minted, and the obviously the picture, and then the properties. Nowhere in here you're going to see any information about. And even if you click on the policy, you're not going to see information about the 777 tag. So that's something that the NFT originator knows, identifies, and then until it's sold, you don't really know until you see how much is taken from profit. So that's pretty much that. But what do you guys think about that? If you have any questions, that's pretty much how it works. It's pretty simple. It's tagged. It's tags. But it is set like that. And oh, the answer to one question I had is, what if multiple people create an NFT collection and you want to be able to split the royalties, because I know that's going to happen. Like you help someone create a collection and they're like, hey, I'll give you 2% of the royalty. And then the actual owner takes the rest. Well, let me go back here. If that happens, then when Cardano, when smart contracts, there has to be a smart contract that basically then divvies up the royalties. At this time with the tags, you can only actually identify one wallet address to receive all the royalties. And so at that point that you receive royalties, it would be up to the holder receiving those royalties to divvy them out. Or you could, and I'm sure we'll be done within the next 30, 60 days pretty soon, create a smart contract that basically takes that royalty fee received and then divvies it up appropriately. And so that's what I think is going to happen in the future. But as of right now, only one address can receive it. It's identified by three tags. It's burned to the policy before the rest of the assets are minted. And all the NFT marketplaces have to adhere to that 777 policy. And it's identified through CIP0027, which you can find out on GitHub. So that's kind of like trying to keep it not technical, but that's the deal. If you are thinking about doing an NFT collection, yes, you can receive royalties. Do it, go for it, and get it done. Because I think it's amazing, and it can be scaled up with smart contracts later. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this. If you have any comments, drop them, and if I can't answer them, I will get with someone who can.